story Eveline in Dubliners. Eveline, who's just over 19, works as a clerk in a department store in Dublin. Her supervisor scolds her in front of customers. She lives with a father who used to beat Eveline's mother before she died. Eveline also has two brothers. One of them has died, and the other has a job decorating churches that takes him all over the country. Eveline has to cook and clean and lives in fear of her father's violence. Her father takes Eveline's salary and whatever money his son sends home. And she has two young children left to her charge, so she's responsible for feeding them and sending them to school. Eveline has a boyfriend named Frank, whom she meets in secret because her father disapproves. Frank has asked Eveline to marry him and move to Buenos Aires. Eveline accepted and has made preparations to leave her difficult life behind. Her bags are packed, she's written letters to her brother and her father, yet Eveline hesitates by the window of the only home she's ever known. She wonders what people will say about her after she's left. She decides to meet Frank at the station. There, Frank takes her hand and tries to pull her along, but Eveline grips the rail of the barrier, terrified to follow. Frank calls to her repeatedly, but she only looks at him blankly. Eveline's predicament reveals how few options are available to a working-class woman in Dublin. Her only option is to marry, but her father attempts to control who she sees socially, forbidding her relationship with Frank and thus forcing her to meet him in secret. Even if she marries Frank, though, her life will be similar to what it is now, taking care of a man and looking after children. She's haunted by her mother's final words, a nonsensical Gaelic phrase open to interpretation, meaning either the end of pleasure is pain or the end of the song is raving madness. The story's end, like the phrase itself, is ambiguous. It's possible that Eveline hesitates to go with Frank because none of her options are appealing or good. She's only known Frank a short time, and his life doesn't seem to be especially stable. Things go badly, she'll be too far away to have any help, and she may not be able to afford to return home. It's also possible that, like the other characters in Dubliners, she's paralyzed by choice.